After one dose of the Moderna and Pfizer vaccines, there's about 90% protection after about 2 weeks. With a second dose is recommended for longer lasting immunity. And it's the same with the Johnson and Johnson vaccine. It takes about 2 weeks to first start seeing that immune response, and then the protection builds from there. All three vaccines are highly effective, and I would have no qualms about taking any one of them. I don't have a preference for any of the vaccines. There's no problem getting a delayed second dose. We do try to get people vaccinated on time, so either 3 or 4 weeks after the first dose of the vaccine. But let's say the supply wasn't there, or for some other reason you got sick and you weren't available to be immunized. Just get vaccinated as soon as you can after that interval. You don't have to restart the vaccine series. And even if you get vaccinated 6 or 7 weeks later, the CDC says that dose is a valid dose and you don't have to restart the series. People who have COVID, we recommend waiting until you're no longer infectious, so you're no longer isolated or in quarantine, and then you may get vaccinated as soon as you feel well enough to get vaccinated. But there's no rush to get vaccinated because reinfection within 90 days of infection is very rare. So the CDC says you can wait up to 90 days later, but there's no minimum interval that you need to wait. We just don't know how long immunity is going to last. We wonder if we're going to need boosters and how frequent the boosters are going to be. So far, what we've seen is that the immune response following immunization is equivalent or better to the immune response that's seen following infection. So we expect at least 3 months of protection and likely longer. But we just don't know. We're going to have to do those studies and follow up. People with underlying medical conditions such as heart, kidney disease, diabetes, lung disease, these people are at increased risk for having severe infections, so they certainly should be immunized. The CDC also recommends that they should be immunized unless they do have a contraindication to vaccination. And many of these groups were included in the studies. People who are immunocompromised, the main concern we have is that they might be at increased risk for severe infection. People with mild immunocompromise were included in the vaccine studies, and they did seem to be protected and have a good immune response with no increased risk of adverse effects. People with more severe immune compromise were not included in the studies, but the CDC does recommend for them to be immunized because they may have protection from the vaccine, and there's no theoretical increased risk of side effects following vaccination. Pregnant or lactating women were not supposed to be included in the studies, but some women became pregnant in the studies or they were missed. And so there is very little safety data, but there's no theoretical reason that we can think of that the vaccines would have an adverse effect on the mother, on the developing fetus, or on the breastfeeding infant. And so we think that that's that women who are pregnant or breastfeeding, that they may be vaccinated. They may want to talk to their doctor about that. When I talk to mothers about this, I've been recommending it because I do feel that the benefits of immunization outweigh the theoretical risks. We know that pregnant women are at higher risk for more severe infection compared to non-pregnant women of the same age. If you've had vaccine side effects, such as a severely sore arm or a bad headache or fever, after you've been vaccinated, you can certainly take antipyretics and anti-inflammatories such as Tylenol, ibuprofen, or aspirin, and that should relieve your symptoms. But it's not recommended to take those prophylactically. There's theoretical reasons to think that if you take those prophylactically before you've been immunized, that might decrease the immune response, and we wouldn't want that. I think if you're feeling sick on the day that you're going to get vaccinated, then don't get vaccinated, because if you get more sick, it'll be hard to know whether that was a side effect of the vaccine or whether that's the natural course of your infection. I think, you know, the CDC and others still recommend universal masking when in public, when you're around people outside your household. That's the best way to prevent another surge of infection. We still have a significant number of people in the U.S. who are still susceptible to disease, who have not been vaccinated, they haven't had infection yet, and so we still feel that we are at risk for additional surges. So right now, we're still recommending continue masking, continue social distancing.